mine and Glenmire. Depend these few lines, for I find that me heart is bethered by a handsome fair maiden who I long for better than life. But from me she is flown and is known as the red-haired man's wife. Oh, I well mind the day I did say that I gave you me life, and you solemnly swore that no more we ever should have. But your mind's like the ocean, with its motion sure it takes on new life. So me heart it is torn, and I mourn for the red-haired man's wife. So a letter I'll send by a friend down to the seashore, to make her understand I'm the man that does her wrong. And if she'd but leave not safe, sure I'd give her me life. She'd live like a queen, and no more be seen as the red-haired man's wife. So I straight took me way one day through a green leafy grove, and I cross burning streams through scenes where birds warbled and roved. 'Twas there in a glade where nature displayed her delights that I stood all amazed, for I gazed on the red-haired man's wife. Oh, I gave her the favour, and I gave it all with me right hand. And she said, young man, would you have me to break God's command? So therefore be easy, do not let nature cause you such strife. I was given away, and I must stay as the red-haired man's wife. Aye, he said, me fair Venus, 'tis alongside of me he shall roll. For the patriarch David had some thousands of wives, sure 'tis well known. So yield to me embraces, and straight put an end to me strife, or else I'll run crazy if I can't gain the red-haired man's wife. May me life never end, or me passion or yearning bait, till you and I do lie neath some great green tree shade, with no one to see us but ourselves in that field all alone. And a red-haired man to be dead with his head beneath a stone.